A few years ago when I was starting my career, a consultant called and yelled at me. Why did you lie to me? You are not taking 23, but 30%. And yet, I didn't lie to him. It was my second or third placement and I was confused and had no idea of what he was talking about. So, what happened? First, before I go further, please subscribe to the channel and turn on the notification bell. It really helps me a lot. Then to answer that question, you actually need to know the difference between markup and margin, because staffing agencies usually calculate their fee in a different way than most people do. And here is how staffing agencies calculate the margin. So the margin is the difference between the selling price and the contractor's rate divided by the selling price. So if the selling price is 650 euro, for example, and the contractor's rate is 500, you take the difference, so 150 euro, and you divide it by the selling price, 650 euro. So your percentage will be 23, because the starting point is the selling price, not to be confused with markup, because markup is the difference between the selling price and the contractor's rate divided by the contractor's rate, not the selling price. So here you take the difference, same here, 150, but you divide it by the contractor's rate, so 500 and not 650, and this is why you will get the 30%. So here the starting point is the contractor's rate, and this is why we don't get the same result. So be aware of that when you are talking to a consultant. If he ever gets confused, it will save you a lot of trouble, because if you ever tell to a consultant that your margin is 23%, what he will usually do is multiply his rate by the margin, so 500 euro times 23%, which give him 115 euros. So he will believe that your selling price is 615 euros, while your margin is actually 150 euros because you use the selling price as the starting point, not the contractor's rate. So the selling price is 650. So always remember that. Staffing agencies are calculating their fee in the following way. So you take the difference between the selling price and the contractor's rate, and you divide the difference by the selling price. That's it. But before you get there, you first need to convince your candidate to show up for the interview. And in this video, I'm explaining you how I reduce interview no-shows by 2. So watch this next and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.